Welcome to the Essential Geopolitics podcast from Stratfor, part of the RAIN network of companies. I'm Emily Donahue. In this podcast, I'm speaking with Ryan Boll, a Middle East and North Africa analyst for Stratfor. Ryan, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
So, Ryan, Israel is planning to formally annex disputed areas of the West Bank, which it has occupied and settled for decades. All of this despite the fact that international law deems such a move illegal. Why is this happening now?
Well, the reason this is happening at this moment is there is a window of opportunity for Israel to act on long-term strategic designs to control the West Bank in one way or another indefinitely. This is the culmination of settlement strategies. It's the culmination of cultivating an alliance with the United States. And in this particular moment, the Israelis have a unity government that was put together in part to make this annexation process happen. So there's a lot of unique things coming together at this moment that really makes this a moment where annexation is a very likely thing to happen in the next few days.
Surely this could prompt unrest.
Well, it's very likely to cause unrest within the West Bank and the Palestinian territories. So we're watching closely to see how that will develop and evolve over time. But that level of unrest is different than it has been in the past. Much of the Middle East has put the Palestinian issue at a different level than they used to. It used to be that the Palestinian issue could cause wars. It could cause major conflicts between states. Now it's something at the bottom of the priority list. We have the Iran-US confrontation and the Iran-Arab confrontation. We have the Syrian civil war. We have problems in Iraq. We have and this year alone, we now have the COVID-19 pandemic. We have a lot of major issues that have swamped the importance of the Palestinian issue, meaning that when we're thinking of unrest, we're really thinking about what Palestinians themselves might do, rather than what we used to see in the past, where big countries would mobilize armies and act that way.
Is there any chance that Israel could change its mind about annexation given international pressure?
It seems very unlikely right now, in large part because international pressure isn't that strong. The United States has given something of a green light to this process. The U.S. is trying to negotiate to figure out what the scope and scale of it will be, but they're more or less giving a green light. The European powers are too divided to be able to carry out an effective sanctions campaign. There just really isn't anybody on the map who's able to pressure Israel in a way that matters to stop this in the next few days.
So if it can't be stopped, let's talk about some of the long-term implications of this annexation.
Well, for one, it definitely makes a Palestinian state a lot more difficult to achieve. And if there's no Palestinian state that emerges in the West Bank or Gaza or both, then the Israelis have a really big long-term problem. They have to figure out what to do with these many millions of Palestinians who will be living either underneath Israeli control or beside it without a state. They have to figure out whether or not they will extend political rights to them, or if they will attempt to put together a state that might be unstable and prone to collapse and needing a lot of Israeli support to continue working, or if they simply decide to ignore the Palestinian political question and just see how long they can manage the Palestinians without a Palestinian state or Palestinian political rights.
Wow. Thank you, Ryan.
Thank you, Emily.
Ryan Boll is a Middle East and North Africa analyst for Stratfor, a RAIN company. If you would like to read his geopolitical forecasts and analysis of this region, subscribe to Stratfor Worldview. Podcast listeners get a special rate. Go to stratfor.com/podcast offer. That's all one word, stratfor.com/podcast offer. I'm Emily Donahue. Thanks for listening.